The first fighter that will be announced, his nickname is Diamond Hands. At 6 feet, 225 pounds, he's a heavyweight. Hails from Maple Ridge, British Columbia. He is a professional hockey and lacrosse player. In the 2012-2013, he was voted CHL's toughest pound-for-pound player. His message to the world is the crown has already been won. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, Diamond Hands, a.k.a. Daniel Amesbury.
Parker and Daniel Amesbury
ended up being the feature of the first round. Here they go.
Amesbury is the young gun and Parker the veteran. Oh, both guys trading punches here in the early going, and Amesbury was caught off balance.
Parker is a heavy, heavy hitter. He's known for throwing the bomb. Amesbury getting the chin strap back up, which has come off.
Amesbury, the smallest of the King of the Rink participants, only around 210 pounds, but great conditioning. He was in good shape. Oh, what a big right! He connected on Parker. Here's Parker. Amesbury went to the left, and that just riled Parker up. And Amesbury is down.
What a tough!
Both guys just absolutely hammered each other.
Amesbury popped back up. He goes to his corner. He looks fine. But right as they re-engage, that was a huge right hand. And all it did was wake Parker up.
That Parker, he throws it, but Amesbury came in on the second reload and just threw a bomb.
Oh, and he came in with a left. Got caught off balance. All along the boards they go. Amesbury with the right to the back of Parker's head. Oh, look at these guys battle.
This is incredible.
If your heart's not beating out of your chest, check your pulse right now, folks.
10 seconds
left in the round. Amesbury got caught spinning. Oh, and they threw a punch from the knees. The horn's out. We're gonna find out why. Look at some highlights.
Here we are right here. Look at Parker getting down. That's the beginning of the fight. And then Amesbury, this is towards the end. He got stuck behind him right there. No let up at all. He tried to turn Parker back around, very respectful. And these guys here, Parker got a wake-up call, I think, Phil, when you're watching it. I think he was a little bit surprised at that punch that came in from Amesbury on the second reload between the two. Incredible start to this.
Round two, underway. Oh, one punch knocked down. Amesbury connected flush onto the forehead of Parker. He's got that 38-year-old strength and some weight advantage over Amesbury. Parker showing some pretty good endurance, and he pushes Amesbury down.
Parker's so strong, too.
Yeah.
No question, Amesbury's the most conditioned athlete here.
Less than half a round to go. Amesbury trying to come in with a right. He connects. He's switching hands here.
He is.
We wondered if he could do that. His hockey fights did not show the ability to throw the left. He has thrown the left. Yeah. And now they both go down.
Parker did turn him around, forced him to go left. You wonder if that was some kind of a methodical find by Parker. Parker's seen so many fights, there's nothing he's not used to.
We might see our first sudden death.
Oh, yeah.
We might see it. And the fans want it. Amesbury, oh, right hook! in the final matchup of this opening round.
The icebreaker is upon us.
30 seconds to determine the winner. Amesbury coming in. Oh, and a knockdown. Seconds in. Parker goes down again.
Here we go.
Clock is stopped again. 24 left.
Keep it going. Parker's off balance. He stumbled a bit. Now he's trying to use the boards. He's trying to get Amesbury into the boards. Amesbury connecting with a few stiff uppercuts. Oh, they both just missed on haymakers. That right hand connected. Another right hand connected. Parker came back with an uppercut, but he falls down.
This is a condition.
We got time here.
Derek Parker, a hero.
He looks stunned. Parker looks stunned. That's it. Oh, that's going to go to the judges.
Winner by split decision, Diamond Hands Daniel Amesbury.
And once again, Amesbury is grossly mismatched in height and weight. But you know what? He has the reach advantage, so he's got that going for him.
This, again, should be an extraordinary fight. There's going to be a lot of punching in this one.
Let's get it all!
Second semifinal and a quick knockdown there is Amesbury, who went down a lot in his first fight. I mean, there were a lot of knockdowns both ways, but he was strong against Parker. But fight a little bit longer, we'll see where conditioning comes into play. They get set to re-engage. And Amesbury can throw the left and the right. Oh, four big hands from Amesbury. Tippin is down.
Oh, and he's pouring.
Oh. He got busted open.
Yeah.
They'll have to work quick to try to stop that nosebleed.
He got, as they got turned, it was a heavy shot.
No, that's it. That is it. Amesbury needed to go the distance against Parker. He did not have to go very long in this bout. A TKO of Chase Tippin, and Amesbury is on to the championship round.
I'll tell you what, that was something to see.
I mean, here's the thing. Tippin was the aggressor, Chris, at the start. He got a couple of good punches in the early going.
That was action-packed. How did you keep up the energy from the first round, my man?
I fucking put in the work, thanks to my sponsors. I fucking was able for the last 2 months to hit the pavement, do the work with my gym, Savard Boxing Club, every day in work, and that's why I was able to do that. So thanks to my sponsors, thanks to my crew who showed up. I'm not done.
All right, you heard it here. Congratulations, kid. Great job, great job.
Now $15,000, and the crown is at stake. AJ Galante between Daniel Amesbury and Justin Sawyer. This is what you were envisioning, weren't you?
It couldn't have laid out any better. These guys earned their spot here. And this is Amesbury. Diamond Hands got literally a tough mountain to climb here.
Well, he lost. Oh, big uppercut from Amesbury, a second one. But Sawyer taking several lefts to the head. Amesbury got it for the early knockout. But the bone saw has Amesbury along the wall. Oh, a little bit of a cheap shove as the refs were looking to break up Amesbury, who's nearly lost his gear.
We got a pause on the clock.
They're going for it. They know what's at stake here.
Amesbury's had issues with that helmet. Yeah. They're trying to get on. Now the strap.
I think the strap
broke. It's the actual. So.
28 seconds still left in this opening round. Amesbury likes to come in quick. A little bit of a quick jab that time. Oh, the helmet came off again.
There it is.
Both guys trading. Amesbury's got the left going.
Oh,
he's got the left connecting. Oh, Sawyer coming back.
Oh, my.
Big right from Sawyer.
God.
Amesbury battling. Trying to free the hands right now. He's tied up.
Oh.
Little bit of a left. Big right hand from Amesbury. Off balance. Regained it. Amesbury an uppercut.
Oh.
Amesbury a right hand. Sawyer comes back. Here comes Sawyer, and they're separated for the moment. As wow. The first round has come to an end, now we're going to start round number two. Here we go. Now it's the second round.
Let's go.
Nearly 10 seconds in. Finally, they grab jerseys. Amesbury got an early right in.
Oh,
2, 3, 4, 5 shots. Sawyer taking a punishment.
Oh.
A beating from Amesbury. Amesbury.
Oh,
big right hand. Sawyer came back.
Oh, uppercut.
Look at this. Look at this.
Toe to toe.
Oh, my God. Diamond hands. Pummeling. Justin. Bonesaw. Sawyer.
That's it!
Diamond Hands! Daniel Amesbury is your king of the ring!
What a tilt. I mean, this Amesbury is fireworks all over the place. Tell you what, he came in here conditioned, and I'll tell you, he just knuckled it up right at the end. That was unbelievable, the energy this kid brings. We have a winner.
Before we get set to King of the Ring champion at center ice, take a quick look at some of the highlights of this one. There's Amesbury, he knows he's the winner. TKO in the second round, let's see some highlights.
Oh, here it is here. These guys were chucking. They ended up getting back in there, and they had both those arm motors going, just throwing them back and forth like a saw. And it came down at the end. They had to call it right there. Amesbury, ferocious fell. He throws the uppercut and that side hook. That just does some nasty damage to people. I'll tell you what, this guy is a future of this sport. And he put on a clinic here tonight, winning the three guys with a combined weight of over 800 some pounds.
Here's the thing. The hands, the ability to throw with the left and the right, the conditioning, and he has set a roadmap. If you're going to fight in Ice Wars in the next one, you better be prepared, and you better train, and you better be in shape, because you got guys like this, and they're coming right down the pipe.
Yeah, and Phil, you nailed it right there, buddy. He absolutely was so far better physically conditioned. That was a difference.
Here's the shirt.
Guys, this was absolutely incredible. We have a decision here. 30 seconds into the second round, the winner, the King of the Ring by TKO, Diamond Hands, Daniel Amesbury! Champ, I need you over here, buddy. We're gonna let him celebrate a little bit. All right, ladies and gentlemen, our first King of the Ring, Daniel Amesbury! What do you gotta say, King?
Fuck, I just gotta say thanks to the sponsors and everyone that came to support me, drove all the way from Vancouver. I don't know what to say, man. I put in the work. I won this shit. Power of the mind. Get with it. I already won this 2 weeks ago in my head. That's why I won.
The crown has already been won. That was his message. But wait a second, ladies and gentlemen. Hold on a second.
Hey, you guys had fun tonight? You want to see more? First and foremost, River Creek Casino and Resort, can't thank you guys enough. Like I said in the press conference, it's one thing to jump on a bandwagon. It's another thing to bring us in when we're at our infant stages, and we will never forget it. Thank you, guys. Daniel, we talked about this. I'm so proud of you. And listen, you are the first ever King of the Ring. But we also talked about the dangerous part of being the king is now that you're a target. John Morasty.
ain't gonna lie, I was pretty impressed. He got my blood going. My wife's gonna hate this, but let's bang. Next Ice Wars.
John Nasty Maresti and Diamond Hands Daniel Amesbury. Who would want to see that? Diamond Hands, this is your night. You earned this. I know how hard you've worked, okay? We had someone special that wanted to come out here. I don't know where she went. Guys, we hope you liked what you saw. Thank you guys for the support. We will be back.
Wow, what a show tonight.
Thank you to Charlie. Everybody who had something to do with this event, like, this is something I've dreamed of for a very long time. Getting challenged by the Nasty Marasty blows my mind. This is a dream come true, man. As crazy as it sounds, I've wanted to fight that guy for a long time. So here we go. I guess it's going down now.
Wow.
Thank you, everybody. River Cree, thank you for the greatest host. We won't forget you guys.